Good morning, students. Today I will teach you on the topic called liquid. As you can see on the screen, small balls like structure. What are these? These are actually molecules. If you compare the image what I had given in the previous class, you can see that here in the picture the molecules are quite far apart. Since molecules are quite far apart, therefore intermolecular force of attraction is less. Since intermolecular force of attraction is less, the molecules can easily slip over each other, due to which they can flow. So liquids are called fluids. They are actually less rigid as compared to solid, because molecules are bit far apart. Here you may feel that it is can be compressed, but we can compress. But as comparison to gases, it can be compressed only to a very limited extent that may not be noticeable in a very easy way. Student, now let us have a comparative study between solid, liquid and gas. Since you are in class 6 and you should know mass. If you do not know, please pay attention to know what is mass. Mass means quantity of matter contained in a body. Since matter remains same in all the states, therefore solids, liquids and gases do have definite. Now let us talk about shape. Since in solids molecules are closely packed, so they have got definite shape. In liquids molecules are bit far apart, so they take the shape of the container. In gases also molecules are quite far apart, so they also take the shape and size of the container. In terms of volume, solids have got definite volume. Liquids also have definite volume. Gases do not have definite volume because in gases molecules are very far apart and they undergo rapid motion, due to which they do not have a definite volume. Since in solids molecules are very closely packed and it is not possible to compress them, due to which solids cannot be compressed. In liquids molecules are a bit far apart, so we can compress liquid to a very limited degree. But in terms of gases, you had seen on the screen that molecules were far apart, and once you apply the pressure on the molecules comes close to each other. Therefore in gases compression is possible to a higher degree. I have told you students, in solid molecules are very closely packed, due to which they cannot flow. But liquids and gases can flow, so they are called as fluids. Since in liquids molecules are very closely packed, so we say that they are highly rigid. To rigid means to say that it becomes difficult to change their shape. In liquids molecules are not very closely packed, so they are less rigid. And in terms of gases, they are least rigid. Already regarding molecules, I have said in solids they are very closely packed, liquids they are quite far apart, in gases they are the farthest apart. Now students, we are dealing with the last topic, that is called kinetic energy. Kinetic energy means it is the energy possessed by a body by virtue of its motion. In solids you have seen that molecules are very closely packed, so we can say that in solids, since molecular force of attraction was very high, due to which kinetic energy was very less. Once you come to liquids, since molecules were quite far apart, therefore kinetic energy could be seen in liquids. Once you compare to gases, since the molecules were very far apart, therefore kinetic energy in gases was to a maximum degree.